Well, that's hard to pick one artist, but I would say Wayne Shorter would be on the list. The Brecca brothers, Mike and Randy, and the experiences that I've had touring with Santana and working with various people in the rock pop world. And the reason is because with Wayne, I mean, I learned so much musically and conceptually from him just from talking to him and performing with him on stage. And I think it was just his fearlessness as a musician and completely open-minded and incredibly focused. And there was something about his demeanor and his concept that I felt really comfortable with. Like, I felt like validated, like all the thoughts that I had about music and what it could be and how open it could be and the kind of blending of genres, even though it was primarily a jazz situation. I just felt really comfortable, and someone of his caliber, you know, an icon, having that approach, it made me feel like I was on the right path. So I guess that helped me to become more comfortable on stage, and I gained a confidence, you know, with my concept, my time, my sound, and I think I was able to project that a lot more after working with Wayne. And the same with the Brecca brothers. With Santana and some of the rock guys, what I learned was to kind of take away the barrier between the musician and the audience. And sometimes it's easier to do that in those situations. Sometimes the jazz situation, there's a little bit more of a barrier. So I learned how to communicate directly with the audience, more so with those guys. So. Well, I guess it would have a lot to do with their mentality. You know, their view of towards music in the world, I guess. You know, because there has to be some compatibility there, and you know, make sure their heads are on straight. And the most important things that they had the ability to play the music well, and it wouldn't have to be, you know, perfect right off the bat, but just if I knew that they had the capability and the willingness to put in the work, and they had you know, a positive attitude, and they would follow through with what they say they're going to do. I think those are the most important qualities. Well, the only thing that I would say, and as far as having a different approach, is more of a sonic aspect. Like, you're playing in front of 10,000 people, you're probably going to be relying more on a monitoring system, either ear monitors or monitors on stage, and not as much acoustics, you know. So, just technically, their dynamics, really.
Thank you.
No, no. I've played in front of 20,000 people with the same drum kit, the same sizes, the same drum heads that I've played in clubs that hold 50 people. The only time I would change the kit is for musical purposes, never the size of the venue or the size of the audience, because my sound is in my hands and my limbs and the dynamics. And I tune the drums very carefully, and specifically for those situations where I can play heavier music or more jazz-oriented music. You know, I like to have a fat sound. I like to be articulate, but musical. But if it was a situation where an 18-inch bass drum would work better musically, then I would change it. But as far as the size of the venue or the size of the audience, that makes no difference to me.